Now, today, record travel is expected out of DIA. It could be the biggest day since March when the pandemic began. Our Jacqueline Quinn is live there tonight. Jacqueline, some mixed reviews from people about their experience at DIA.
Mac, it really depends on who you ask and their experience traveling. But right now, you're seeing a bit of an evening rush here. We've been here all day, and I can tell even during midday, it just didn't seem that busy, and the numbers are not even close to what they've been in years past. Lines from the roads, lines to get through security, and lines to pick up baggage. But there's still a breeze compared to the normal crowds during Thanksgiving weekend.
Their lines are terrible. They're not social distancing. Planes are full. They're not making people wear their masks.
Correct. Abriana Bibbs and her mom thought their holiday trip to Vegas wouldn't see as many people packed together.
It's disappointing, so we probably won't be traveling again.
Denver International Airport is estimating almost 40,000 people will go through the checkpoint today, which is down about half from last Thanksgiving weekend.
Everyone had masks on,
so it didn't really.
Yeah, that's fine.
The Williamsons came back from St. Louis. They say their trip was smooth.
It felt like it was normal, which is kind of like
it was full, but
nice.
It was fine.
DIA has also added measures to keep people safe from COVID-19, including sanitizing stations and frequent cleaning, and increased trains to avoid crowding. But until there is a widely available vaccine, passengers will be cautioned against travel.
Now, the concern is what's going to happen to these COVID numbers after Thanksgiving. There is expectation that it will go up. Now, we're hearing that there may be a vaccine that arrives in Colorado in mid-December. But again, it all depends on when that becomes widely available. And it's likely we're going to hear cautions against traveling through Christmas. For now, reporting at Denver International Airport, I'm Jacqueline Quinn, covering Colorado First.